Hello, God bless you. I'm Anna, I'm out of Chicago, Illinois. And on today, I'm still working on last week, so I'm on my day 7. And the thing that I would like to share on today, very briefly if I can, is to tell you what fear has cost Anna. Fear has cost me so much as I look back, and I'm not going to say regretfully or remorsefully, but I am going to say I'm looking back and I'm not really liking what I see. Okay, that's what I am going to tell you. It's sad, but it's true. And I'm praising God that He's allowed me to even get where I am. But I have put God on hold. The other day when I wrote in my mirror work, I had to confess to the Father, my Heavenly Father, that I needed His forgiveness for putting him on hold. And the reason that I'm saying that is because I have not given myself every opportunity to let the strengths and the gifts, the callings, and the value of my life be made manifest in my life to other people because of fear. And because of also having a negative connotation of fear. Sometimes when you think like the world thinks and you don't have anybody to transform your thinking, until you get to that place where you say, oh, I get it now, I see it now. Well, I'm right there right now, I see it. Okay, it could have been a positive launching instrument for me, but unfortunately, a lot of ways I have not allowed it to be that. So one thing that fear has cost me greatly is lost time in being consistent and following through on things that were my endeavors. I have been in several network marketing endeavors, and I've really put a lot of energy into them, I might add. However, the follow-through and the feedback and the success that I saw other people receiving while they were teaching me what they were doing, I tried to emulate what they were doing, it wasn't working for me. And so what I did was I put that on the back burner and gave myself into another endeavor, or I quit. Or I decided to feed my sorrows by spending money in other areas, that stuff that I did not need to spend money on, taking time to drive where I needed to go, and consoling myself because of my unsuccessful endeavors. Fear can cost you a lot when you don't even recognize that it's fear that's driving you. You thought you were driven. You thought you were the one that was in control, but when you look up and find out that you are going around in a circle and landing in the same spot where you started, it hasn't benefited you anything but time lost, having to start over, and not making progress. So that's number one. Actually, it's number two and one. It's one and two, because while I, you know, didn't give my full, wasn't all in efforts to making sure that I didn't allow the obstacles in my life to designate me a failure. I was as busy spending money that I didn't need to spend. I could have been investing it or doing something that would be more valuable to me, finding out how other people use money and how other people can take, you know, what was meant for evil and work good out into the saving of your life for things that are going to come to become a need for you in the future. So that would be number one and two. The third one is that fear has caused me the loss of so many relationships due to drawing back and not really investing in creating relationships that were long-term, just being superficial and surface-minded, letting my emotions dictate to me how it is that I thought life was supposed to be. So I'm working on building intimacy. And even though I might not be as young as I would like to be, I still, you know, thank God that I have breath in my body and I can still look future forward and say, I know now what has hindered me and I can work on those things and cause my life to be expanded. Yeah, expand it. You see, expand it. And the fourth thing is that fear has caused me failure and seeing my own personal worth as needful and valuable to others. It's like if you're so self-indulgent or you're so self-centered that you don't think anybody else needs you, then you will never be valuable to anyone but you, and then that would be so minutely limited that nothing that you say or do will ever make a difference. Who's going to know and who's going to care? And I think that I just have been just so uninspired toward being a servant leader in that area of using every part of my life to be a benefit to other people. And I'm not banging myself and debasing myself. I'm not really, but I really, really realize that there's a lot that have been missed. There's a lot that has been missed. And so fear has cost me a lot in that. And the last part I wrote is that in my reputation, you know, you tell people, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that, I'm going to do this. And they're going to say, okay, where is it? And so your reputation is really at stake. If you go and say to someone that, you know, I'm a businesswoman, I've got this website, I've done this, I can do that. And, you know, it's just idle talk. Idle talk. And it costs you your reputation because it appears that you don't have the integrity that you should have. So in a nutshell, with 6 minutes, that's really what I would like to share, though I don't really want to share it because it seems to me it's kind of embarrassing. But it is what it is. So this is Anna. Please comment. Let me know what you think. I appreciate you so much. God bless you. Bye.